everybody. My name is Valentine. I'm one of the maid of honors for tonight. Thank you all for coming and celebrating this special day for Ashley and Forrest. Now, there's so much that I can say from my dear sister right here, who taught me so much in life, and, you know, she's the oldest of us, of the batch. I would just like to thank you for everything that you've done for me in life. You know, you're such a huge inspiration for me. You're such a role model, and you've done everything that you possibly can for not only for me, but for my daughter and for my family. And I can't, you know, I'm just so glad I'm so glad you chose me to be here on your special day and celebrate your new life as Mrs. Simon. You know, not only have you... Okay, you're just making me cry. Okay. You have, one of the things I love about you is that you have such a great and kind heart. You go above and beyond for everyone, and that's one of the things I admire you for. I'm glad whenever you're having a bad day and want to vent to someone, you call me, even when I'm crying and having a bad day, because then we can cry together. Let me see. I love the way that you spoil me and spoil Lana like Danae used to spoil me. I can't thank you enough for everything, but most of all, thank you for helping me write this speech. Also, thank you, Forrest, for being there for her when I can't be or don't always know what to say. I can't wait to watch y'all go through this beautiful journey together. As I said before, or I forgot to mention, but Ashley is the oldest of us siblings, but I'm happy to gain one more brother tonight. May your dreams become one dream and your lives become one life. Welcome to the family, Forrest. I wish you nothing but love and happiness.
Hello, everybody. My name is David. here goes. Fornication. Sorry, I'm very nervous. For an occasion such as this, Forrest, I'd like to present the only couple of minutes that Ashley did not plan in today's wedding. There comes a time in a person's life when they meet their true love and their PIC. Partner in crime, for those that don't know. And for Forrest, I know that moment came when Ashley courageously and in an unorthodox fashion introduced him to me. It's an honor to be here celebrating Ashley and Forrest's commitment to each other and the fact that they did that in front of all their friends and all their family. I can't say that I'm the one here that has known Forrest for the longest or that knows the most about him, but friendship isn't a measurement of time, but of a bond. And Forrest, I know that you, of all people, can have the best of bonds with anybody in any room. And I know for the rest of your life, you're going to do that with Ashley. Thank you. Love you, bye.
Hi, I'm Sandy. I'm the aunt of Ashley. My speech is kind of long, but I hope I can summarize it a little bit. But okay. Hello, everyone, and thank you for being here today to celebrate these two awesome individuals in the next chapter of their lives. I became an aunt at the very young age of 6 years old to a beautiful blue-eyed baby girl who's sitting here tonight, the beautiful bride. From the moment you were born, you and I had an undeniable connection. All you ever wanted was to be who I was, and all I ever wanted was to protect you. The funny thing is, though, now that we are here in this place, much older, I must confess that the tables have turned a whole lot, and you're the one that I look up to, and I'm the one that you constantly protect. Before the real tears begin, I'm gonna let y'all in on some sweet memories. Ashley always wanted to be me growing up. The first pet I ever had was a little Chihuahua, and she got the same one. They both have passed on now, but that But in that moment, I realized that the little human being was following in my footsteps. From cheerleading to our first cars were the same. Jetta's, of course. Ashley picked the same one. She moved to San Antonio and followed after me, and I couldn't have been more happier. Once I was away from my parents and I had time to reflect, I thought, what did this little girl want to be me? Why did she want to be me? I had done so much wrong in my life, I would never want her to do the same. Our time as roommates came to an end when she went to Tyler with her mom to pursue her degree and be with her mother and brother. I didn't think I would cry, but I remember doing so really hard. Like I was 7 years old again and saying goodbye, like whenever she moved out of our house. Just a few months old, her mom and her moved away. There were no more car rides with my dad holding her in her car seat in between the seats in the minivan, you know, no seatbelt, just totally unsafe, but that's where she fit. It was cute then, obviously not safe now, but it was back in the day. Fast forward to when we're here older, Ashley ended up moving to San Antonio again years later, right down the street from where I, my first home that I had ever gotten all on my own. And at this point, I was a mom. That year was the hardest, as you can remember, Ashley. The year that I met Forrest, they both came to stay with me and looked at apartments, and they got one down the street. That year being the hardest, I was fighting my own battle, and these two took me in multiple times and gave me a place and my child to stay. My electricity had been cut off because I was paying court costs, and Ashley and Forrest cooked for me every single night. They entertained my son while I worked and cared for my pets when I wasn't able to. They were so strong even back then, and I have no doubt that they'll be strong going forward. Y'all are the best and the funnest roommates I ever had. My car wouldn't start, and I would call Ashley and Forrest, and she would just come in like pure magic and just turn the key and it started. And I was like, what in the world? Yeah, that was many times. And she would call me to, you know, talk Forrest out of an argument whenever they weren't getting along, and I had no problem doing so. I keep mentioning Ashley, but Forrest, I just want you to know how much I am truly glad that Ashley found you. We had some unforgettable nights in Chicago. He's been the one to always show up whenever I had to move again for the millionth time with his pickup truck and move me wherever I needed to go. Most importantly, he was the one out of nowhere who recently came up and told me that, Sandy, I've been praying for you every day. This speech has gotten a little emotional, but I don't care. I love you two more than anything in this world, and I'm so happy to be a part of this day, and I'm happy to be a part of y'all's lives. Ashley, you've grown into a beautiful young woman, driven, creative, organized, rooted in God, and the most caring individual I know. Forrest, you're a special kind of person for putting up with her and for all these females that he puts up with no problem whatsoever. You're so patient, so supportive in everything that Ashley wants to do and everybody that she loves. I'm more than proud of both of you and everything that y'all do, and I wish y'all the best of luck. I love y'all.
Life was dull until you came. I was breathless when we first met. Couldn't keep my hands away.